Well, hey, welcome to week 4 of Choose Your Own Adventure. I'm so excited because today we are going to be talking about faith and our hope and trust in who God is. And today's big idea is this right here, is that I can be wise by choosing God. You know, sometimes in our lives we have a lot of different choices that are going on, and sometimes we forget to choose God. So today we're going to share about how we can choose God. But before we do that, let's pray and ask God to be with us. God, we love you and we thank you. God, I pray today as we talk about our faith in you, God, would you help us realize and be more aware of your presence in our lives. God, I pray that you would speak to us even right now. And God, I pray that we would spend more time with you this week intentionally so that we can know who you are more. God, we love you and we thank you. And in your name, amen.
Hey, little chicken nuggets, it's me, Corey Fairpot. Welcome to Real TV. Welcome back to your ongoing pirate adventure, y'all. Well, for the past several weeks, I've had to make several choices on my own. Some of those choices were to do good instead of bad. To choose my words carefully, if I'm being honest, I've learned quite a bit. I mean, in that time, I've also chose to become a full-time pirate. I mean, I got a treasure map for crying out loud. Speaking of that, I need your help. Since I've been making so many decisions by myself lately, I figured I'd get to ask you guys for help. Y'all want to help me on my next step of my adventure? What do you say? Will you help me? Yay, awesome. Thank you so much. Well, let's get started. Since last week, I've narrowed down where the treasure would be. This map has led me exactly to the spot. And now all I have to do is start digging. First, I need some things figured out. Once I dig this treasure up, I'll be a bona fide legendary pirate. So I'll need a good pirate name. And I can't just be Captain Coral. So here are the choices you need to make. Will my name be Captain Coral Reef Carl or Captain Sudsy McFishy Pants? Which one do y'all think? All right, so now y'all get to refer to me as Captain Sudsy McFishy Pants. I like it, it rolls off the tongue. All right, so now besides a rapidly declining dental health, here's a few things all pirates have. Number one, a sidekick. When going on an adventure, you need to have someone beside you who you can trust. Now the usual is to have a parrot, but I'm definitely terrified of birds. So it's either a sock puppet or a spider. You choose. A sock puppet, really? I figured a spider would be more helpful with 8 hands and all, but oh well. All right, last thing. All pirates have an eye patch, so you gotta choose which eye I can never see out of again. So do you choose the right eye or the left eye? Right eye? Well, if you say so.
Carl!
Oh, hey, Andrew!
Carl, I just want to tell you, even though pirates might wear eye patches, it's probably not for the reason that you think.
Really?
They would actually use it and take it off when they go inside the ship so that they would have one eye that was already used to the dark.
What? Really? I figured a seagull had plucked it out.
Nope.
Well, that's a relief. Well, I better get digging.
All right. Good luck, Carl. Hey, kids. How you doing? Well, I'm so glad to see you all helping Carl make big decisions, because that's great practice for what we're talking about today. Well, I've told you before, but in this life, we're going to face choices every single day. Choices that determine who we'll hang out with, what we enjoy, and who we'll become. But do you know the one choice that we're given by God? It's the choice of who we decide to live for. Well, it might sound weird, but everyone you meet is choosing something to live for, whether they know it or not. It kind of comes down to what you find most important. Some people live for money because they see that as most important. Some live for experiences or fame. But it's important to know that we all have something that we choose to live for. The question is, who or what will you choose? Because money, fame, and experiences, they all fade and go away. So wouldn't we want to choose something that'll last forever? Well, there's one thing that'll last forever, and that's choosing God. Well, think about it. God, the one who created the sun, the moon, the stars, the ocean. Well, God even created the platypus. Seriously, look at this thing. Is it a duck? Is it a beaver? Who knows? But God created it. So if I was gonna decide someone to live for, I would probably choose God. I mean, God gave me my life in the first place. Not even just that, Jesus gave his life so that I could live for him. How great is that? And I know that might all sound intimidating or scary, but don't worry, because in Proverbs 3, it encourages us to trust in the Lord with all our hearts and lean not on our own understanding. So even when it gets tough or confusing in life, we know we can trust God. And get this, in verses 1 and 2, we get another promise. Listen, Do not forget my teaching, but keep my commandments in your heart, for they will prolong your life many years and bring you peace and prosperity. Those words come from the Bible. It's telling us that if we listen and obey God, our life will be long, full of peace and gifts from God. Why wouldn't we want to choose something so awesome? If we don't choose God, the other option won't give us what was just promised to us. Sure, there will be moments of happiness and acceptance, but ultimately, it's gonna leave us feeling empty. We were created to love and worship God. Choosing anything else will never fill us up the way that God can. So, we can lean in and trust in God in everything we do. And trusting in God is probably the wisest thing someone can do. So remember, we can be wise by choosing God.
Well, you heard it. Our big idea today is I can be wise by choosing God. And so let's say it out loud on the count of three, as loud as we can, okay? One, two, three. I can be wise by choosing God. Yes. Woo! Perfect. Wonderful job. Excellent. You could not have done it any more perfectly. So proud of every single one of you. You're gonna make me cry.
Hi, Andy.
Carl, how's it going? Did you find the treasure?
You bet your sweet, salty face I did.
Well, don't keep us in suspense. Tell us what it is. What did you find?
Are you ready for this?
Yup.
I can't hear you.
Carl, just show us.
Check it out.
What? Is that it? Is that an apple?
Yep, apparently the map was just a map to the local farmer's market, so.
Yep. Oh, well, that's unfortunate.
Yep. See you later, kids.
I'm actually allergic to apples.
Man, I love today that we learned about no matter what you're going through, we can choose God and choose His presence. You know, for me, choosing God is sometimes hearing about other people and what God is doing in their lives, or even choosing God that He's near to me and He's close to me, and knowing that He's always close, always hearing my prayers. You know, it says that in James that when you're sick or when you're in trouble, that you should call people and pray. And that's what I love, is that we're not meant to do this alone. We're able to ask people and say, hey, you know what? Man, I'm feeling really upset, or this is really bothering me. Would you pray with me? And people will pray with you. You know, another thing that I love is that when we pray, it's just like the same thing that happens. We feel kind of close to that person that's praying because they're saying something personal to our lives. And it's something that when they pray specifically, we feel like, man, God is hearing our prayers. Did you know that God is always near to us? Did you know that sometimes when we feel like God can't hear our prayers, He's hearing our prayers and He's doing things even though we are not seeing it? I love that song that says, you're working even though I don't see it. And I love that we can be reminded that God always loves us and cares for us because He is always close to people that have needs. You know, when we pray, it's something like this. Have you ever had someone, when they're an adult and they're taller than you, and they get down on your level and they talk to you and they look you in the eyes and they have interactions or things like that? It's just like that. When we pray, it's like God getting down on a knee and cupping His ear and allowing Him to hear our voice and allowing Him to respond to our needs and our prayers. You know, this whole time we've talked about choose your own adventure and how we've talked about following God even when it's hard, or following in our actions and words, and following and choosing God in every circumstance that we have in our lives. I want to ask you something. I want you to think about this for this week, or maybe in the next 2 weeks, is how can you choose God more often? Is it maybe reading your Bible more and not playing video games or having screen time as much? Or maybe it's asking someone to pray for you. Or maybe it's having a conversation with God. You know, God is like a friend to us. He's just like our best friend. And so maybe sometimes it's asking God to be with us when we're nervous or afraid, or maybe when we have a problem and we don't know the answers. And instead of us trying to figure it out, we ask God to be with us. I don't know about you, but sometimes I forget that God is always near me. He's always close by. And so something that I want to challenge myself with is asking God that I be more aware of His presence in my life. You know, God is omniscient. You guys remember that? That He is everywhere. He's all-knowing. He's omnipresent. That's everywhere. Omniscient is He's all-knowing. He's everywhere at once, and He knows everything. And with that, I know that God is always near. So I want to ask you again, what is one thing or maybe something that you can do to spend more time with God this week? Maybe it's spending every night reading a Bible story before you go to bed. I don't know what it is, but we're going to pause and take 10 seconds and we're going to ask God that question right there. It's going to pop up on the screen. I want you guys to ask God this question right here. How can I choose God more often? You know, maybe you need to put like a sticky note that says, I choose God everywhere you ever, like maybe when you brush your teeth, because you're supposed to be brushing your teeth every day, so that you can make a reminder that you choose God every day. That when you're afraid, you remind yourself, I choose God because He does not want me to be afraid. Or when you're anxious or nervous, you choose God because He doesn't want you to be anxious or nervous about something. Because He wants us to trust Him. Just like we read in Proverbs 3, chapter 5 and 6, it says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge Him and He will make your paths straight. I love that verse. I want to pray for you real quick, because I know that when we choose God, God will give us wisdom, but also sometimes we get distracted by other thoughts. And that's because the enemy doesn't want us to choose God every day. I want to pray for you real quick. Let's pray and let's ask God that He'll allow us to choose Him every day and remind us of that, but also that the enemy won't distract us from choosing God. Let's pray. Jesus, I thank You so much. God, I thank You that we get to choose You every day. God, maybe it's giving up a little bit more video game time to spend time with You. Or maybe it's just asking to be more aware of Your presence in our lives. But God, I pray that we would choose You not only today, but every day of our lives. And God, I pray at the same time that the enemy wouldn't distract us or make us feel like choosing You is not important, because God, choosing You is the most important thing we can do every day. God, would You give us wisdom? God, would You give us understanding? And God, would we see Your presence in our lives and Your voice in our lives as we choose You each and every day. God, we love You and we thank You. And in Your name, amen. Man, what an incredible lesson today on choosing God and choosing Him in every circumstance of our lives. Well, sadly, it is time to go. And man, I'm so bummed, because I enjoyed this series of us choosing our own adventure, and know that choosing our own adventure means including God and reading His word so that He can direct our paths, just as His word says. I pray that you would know that God loves you and that God wants to take care of you in every moment of your life. And I pray that He would always speak to you. Until next time, have a great week and have a great day. Take care. Bye-bye.